Hello, today we are going to make a photo slideshow or a picture slideshow in DaVinci Resolve 16. For the purpose of this tutorial, we will need some pictures, a folder of pictures, and I will be using a background and a sound effect, which will play whenever the picture appears on the screen. The idea is to make the first page of the slideshow and then make the others by replacing the pictures and export them, and finally eventually combine them in one file. So let's get started. As you can see, I have two pictures. One is colored and one is in black and white. The idea here is to add both of the pictures as the slide page, and then they will appear one after another, as you can see shortly. Let me add this first to the timeline, and I will change the duration of this to 2 seconds first, and I will need a text which will represent the caption of the picture. But first, let me move this to the left, select the picture on the timeline and go to the transform position X, write a value of -490, and then I will go to the effects library, I will go to the titles and add a text on a new track at the end of the picture's length. We'll change the duration of this clip as well to 2 seconds. 02. Now move the timeline. Let me increase the length of the picture to go to the ending of the text. The reason I leave this gap over here is because we will have the picture show first and then the caption of the picture. But we need to move this caption on top of the picture. So with this clip selected, go to the transform tool and move it upwards to the left upper corner, and then I will change the size to 70. We'll change the font as well and make it bold. Maybe we can move it even a little bit higher. Then I will go to the background of the text and change the height of it to somewhere like this, and then change the opacity to 70. I will go back and write colored here. Okay, the next thing we need to do with the caption is to go to the video tab, and I will crop it to the left so that it fits within the picture boundaries. Okay, this is good, then crop to the right, 596. This is good. The next thing we need to do now is add the other picture, go to the media pool and add it to the timeline. This will show up after the text appears. So we will select the second picture, go to the transform, and I will add the value of 490 to move it to the right. We'll change the clip duration to 2 seconds, 02. And lastly, since the text will be the same, I will add, copy this text, copy and paste it, and then move it above the second picture. Increase the duration. I will increase the duration of the first text and of the first picture, because once they appear, they will be visible through the end of the slide. Now we need to work with the text for the second picture. I will select it, and then I will go to the video tab and move it to the right. Change the position. Make sure it fits just above the picture on the right. And finally, for this slide, I will add another effect, which will be the whole slide effect. I will go to the effects library in the titles. I will go to the and select the lower 3D sample box thin line and add it here. Now we need to do some adjustment. Go to the main text. I will write slide page one here. We'll change the text to be bigger. Make the text bold and change the background color to, I will go to the background controls and change the background colors to black. And I will increase the background height to somewhere like this. Let me just increase the duration of the other clip so that play. First, I will change the duration of this clip, change the duration to 4 seconds. And then I will slide all of the other clips to the end. And finally, I forgot, I will add a new track. Add a track here, and I will move the track down. Go to the media pool, I will add the background here. We want the background to be less visible, so we will decrease the opacity. And the final thing we need to do right here is just add the transitions and play the sound effect. So go to the effects library, go to the video transition for the picture. I will add the triangle iris effect also for the picture above, while for the text I will add the barn door and add a barn door over here too. But since the transition is too big here, I will change the duration of transition to 0.5 seconds. Select them all and okay, select this too. Now we are good. Finally, I will add the effect over here, so the sound effect should, let me zoom in, should play as the transition begins. Okay, this sounds good. Let me decrease the size. I will copy this transition, this sound effect, and move it to the second transition. Move the timeline where the second transition of the second picture starts and paste it over here. And now we are done with this, the first slide of the slideshow. Let me play it from the beginning and see what we got. Okay, lastly, I will just add the alpha value of the background of the slide page one text so that is fully visible. And we are done. Now we can see the fun part, and I will show you how quickly it is to add the other pages of the slideshow. And finally, in the end, we will compile them and bring them all together in one file. Now we need to export and render this slide. We will go to the render page. I will go to the YouTube. We'll write for a slide one for the file name. I will make it MP4. Go to the slideshow folder and I will save it over here. Add it to the queue and I will start rendering. Now to add the second slide page, it's very easy. I will go to the edit page. All we need to do is select the first picture from a media pool, right click and replace the selected clip. go to the folder and choose the picture you want to replace it with, and then go to the second picture, go to replace, select clip, and I will select the second picture, and then we will need to change the text from color to before, and then right after for the text on the right, and for the slide page on the right just 2. Then go to the render, change the file name to slide2, add it to render queue, and start rendering. Okay, the second slide page is done, and I will quickly do third and the final slide page. Okay, so now we are done with all the slide pages. Finally, we will bring them all together. In a real project, you might want to create a new DaVinci project, but I will be using the same project to do that, just so that I don't move to another file. I will delete all of what we have in the timeline currently, and then I will go to the import media, go to the folder we saved the slides, and we will add them. Now we have slide 1, slide 2, and slide 3. Just add them to the timeline one after the other. And we are done with this. Let me play it from the beginning and see what we got as a final result. Well, this is all for this tutorial. Hopefully you can use this technique for your next project. If you have any comment or question, or if you want to add something, you can do that in the comment section below. I hope you liked something from this project. Hopefully you learned something. See you next time. Bye.